We have planned this for a while because Dina, so we're not only is she gorgeous and we love her, we're so proud of her. What she's done is taken her stage show, taken her comedy show, you know, and turned it into a, like your onstage comedy routine, turned it into a show called One Funny Mother.
Yes, exactly. I just kind of figured after a while, all I did was talk about was torturing my children and how I thought I was a nut job and my husband's a fool. And I was like, gosh, this is like a show about everyone's life. And so 8 years ago, we launched the first show at the Pittman Theater. And I was like, hey, I have this idea. I want to do the show. And they were gracious enough to let us put the show up. And so we toured the show for a few years. And then I got this great job doing warm up in the city, and I put the show in a closet in my basement, and it sat there for 3.5 years. And then a few years ago, I love doing warm up. I loved working in the, with
just
audiences.
So the people know, warm up is for stand up comics is before the Anderson Cooper show or whatever you were doing. Nate Berkus.
I did Nate Berkus, Anderson Cooper. I did the Chew a couple times.
Didn't you do
Rachel Ray,
Katie Couric,
Meredith.
You had your own show too.
I did. We did a pilot for a show, but it never went anywhere. But I had kind of stayed in that warm up range forever, and it's a great job for a comedian to get a warm up job. Is an amazing job. It's regular work, and I was very grateful for.
So before the audience comes out and sees Anderson Cooper sit and talk to his guests,
they hang out with us.
You go out there and talk to the audience.
Pump them up, get them ready, you know.
And all of my friends who saw either show, because my friends always go, you know, they're bored housewives, what else they gonna do, so they go to shows in the city, and they all said, like, we were so mad when Anderson came on because we didn't want Dina to leave. And I'm like, you're morons, because that you were there for his show.
You were here for the Anderson Cooper show.
But they all said you were so good at
that's
that.
That's so nice.
So now you've taken the show off Broadway.
So that's what we did. So we kind of took the show back out of my closet. I'm like, you know what? This is a great show, and I'm going to start touring it again. So we toured, and then we did 4 weeks last year, this time last year, at the Players Theater downtown. And when we were done, investors came along and said, hey, we want to invest in your show. We want to bring it back. And I was like, I don't know what that means. And then all of a sudden, for the last year, we did a Kickstarter and we raised some money. And then we just launched last Thursday at New World Stages in New York. And it's just amazing.
And you were sick as a dog.
I was sick as a dog, so I don't remember it, unfortunately, my big launch off Broadway. I woke up around the second act, and I was like, hey, look what I'm doing. so that was fun.
Did you walk a red carpet for the premiere?
No, you know what? Our official opening night isn't until the 14th of April, so these are previews, essentially. So press come. So that starts tonight. The preview week
starts
tonight.
We're so proud of you, and such big fans of yours.
It's exciting.
Really.
This chick can do anything. She's amazing. Makes me nauseous. That's why I didn't want her here. Because whenever I'm near her, I always feel like such a loser. Wait,
can I tell you a secret?
Yeah.
Beats her kids.
I'm telling you, that's why I come here. I'm like, oh God, thank God Dennis and Judy are having me in today. I can leave you.